start of the Great Glen Way. Left rugby at 6:45 this morning, so 10 hours to get here. Anyway, it's going to rain tomorrow, but I think we're going to be alright today. We've got 79 miles. Straight Caledonian Canal, Loch Ness, into Inverness. Imagine it. Weather's turned out lovely. It's about 5:30, maybe 4:15. So I've got here late. So I've got two plans. Plan A is a campsite. If I swing off right at Neptune staircase. So I reckon that take me 2 hours. 7:30. So I might stop there. Or carry on to my swing bridge, but that's 9 miles, which means I'll get there late. But tomorrow it's going to piss down all day, so it would make tomorrow much shorter. So we'll see. I'll see what the time is when I get to Neptune staircase and go from there, I think. Oh yeah, well, I've got a dodgy toe, which of course I left rather than going to see the doctor about it. So a week before I set off, it started giving me loads of jip. So we'll see how we go with that as well. Typical bloke. It's the remains of Inverlochy Castle there. Just walked straight past it. Can't park that there, mate.
Steady as the stars in the wood, so happy hearted in the warmth, rang true inside these bones.
There we go.
We sang.
Right, so the Great Glen Way follows the Great Glen fault line between Fort William and Inverness, along the Caledonian Canal, along the length of Loch Ness, and then down into Inverness. So apparently it's been inactive. The last tremor was 1901. So we should be okay. Hopefully. So Neptune staircase. So I'm here a bit ahead of schedule, but I reckon it's another 6 miles to my swing bridge, and there's a cafe over there. We might even sell booze, and there's a campsite over there. So I've decided to push on. I might as well get a few miles out of the way tomorrow. It's going to be chucking down with rain. Look, it's lovely now. Not a soul about either. I can poop along in my own time. Didn't stop for a pint. Didn't get a McDonald's. Gonna wait for my dehydrated chicken tikka. I know how to live. made it to Moy Swing Bridge. Been here about an hour or so. Everything's locked up, unfortunately. But apparently the guy might be in early, so there is a toilet here. Maybe use that in the morning. Pitched up, there's a nice little spot here. Be really quiet. Easy house, easy shed. Just see the top of Ben Nevis over there. Lovely job. Morning, so it's about up past 6, maybe 6 o'clock, day 2. Getting early starts though because it's due to piss it down. A bit weird in the night, about 3 o'clock a whole load of cyclists went by. 3 o'clock this morning, I don't know what was going on, but anyway. So, just got my brew on. Still at the swing bridge. Nice. So I'm heading up to Gearlockie. It's only a couple of miles. It's just starting to rain. I've got one of those keys, the canal keys that you buy from the, well, you rent for a tenner. So it gets you into all of the lockside facilities, so toilets, showers, whatever. So I'm going to head there now. See if I can warm up a bit. It was freezing last night. And we'll go from there. And hopefully, a little bit less canal walking today because this is doing my Sweden. So this is the shower block and toilets at Gearlockie. It's a bit further than you think. So you come past the sort of white house cottage. And it's just there. So if you've got one of the keys, got a drying room as well, well worth it. Outside tap, if anyone needs it, happy days. This is an old World War II landing craft, apparently. Restored and presented thanks to the generosity of various people and organisations. Pretty impressive, isn't it? Concrete structure stands as the remains of an original practice landing craft used by the commandos in training during World War II. A bit of tree cutting going on. Look at that. Quite a long way up now. Just see the lock through the trees. A not a bad view, it's piecing it down. Some people camping over there. I'm going to head to this little hut, hopefully it's empty. So wait off. Put my waterproof trousers on. And then head on to Laggan in an hour or so. So I'm at Laggan. It's just rained all day basically. However, I did manage to catch like a 10 minute break in the rain to get my tent up. But as you can see, it's not the greatest pitch, but it'll do. And then there's a little pub barge up there called the Eagle Barge. So I've just been sat in there all afternoon. Brilliant. Happy days. So I made it to the Eagle Barge. Pitched up in the rain. Just having a couple of drinks. Leaving Laggan. I'm only going to Fort Augustus today, so not far, about 11 or 12 miles. This is the Eagle Barge. The beers last night. Unfortunately, it doesn't open until midday on a Sunday, which means there is nowhere to get food at all from, well, pretty much Fort William to Fort Augustus. There's a cafe apparently. Route, but it doesn't open on a Sunday, so the other choice would have been to head off over there and go to Invergarry and try and find a calf. So it's going to be peanut M&Ms and coffee to keep me going. I've got some mashed potato if I get desperate. Living the dream. This is the Invergarry Station project apparently. More like a museum. Oh, here we are. But they're relaying some of the old line. I just had a quick look, apparently the line hasn't been in use since 1947. So there we are, there you have it. The visitor centre. Up, but it is Sunday morning. No cafe, no bacon rolls. Not that I'm hungry. trailblazer site. And the toilet block, not a bad little spot actually. This is a cluffy lop, I think. Obviously draining it.
Oh, but this is a river, but
four canoes are better dragging canoes around. This is quite a lock. Some wild camp spots just over the other side, apparently. Toilets, I'm not sure if there's showers. Hopefully there's a tap. Need to fill up my water. I might have a walk over and have a look at the wild camp spots. Might be useful for somebody else. Not a bad little spot. Fire pit, maybe get, I don't know, not that great ground. Maybe a couple of tents. A bit over there, a bit rooty, not that flat. Not bad though. I tell you, I'm looking forward to getting off this towpath and up into those hills tomorrow. This is pretty relentless walking at the moment on my feet. Not far from Fort Augustus though. All good. Augustus. Looks like there's a pub. Cracking. I've got a couple of hours before I can check in to my B&B tonight, so happy days. I'm going to go and have a look around. It's nice. For tonight, more Rags Lodge. Got breakfast tomorrow, packed lunch. There's a bar here, ensuite as well. Tent drying, a bit sleeping in the tent tonight, I tell you.